My name is Jody. I'm a gym rat. I'm not a bodybuilder by any means. I've just spent at least 15 hours a week in the gym for the past year or so. Prior to that, I have been training on and off for about 3 years. I decided to go more often after my girlfriend dumped me. We were high school sweethearts, but she went off to a state college and I stayed home. I got a transfer from a community college to a state college. Not all of us can get scholarships, you know. We grew apart and eventually, she told me she was seeing someone else. I use that bit of information as a sort of fuel for my exercise. It helps me take out my anger in a constructive way that improves my overall health. Also, it feels pretty good. I usually go to the gym with my buddy Ross. But he said he was staying home because he felt sick. We are so close he even suggested I should get myself checked. This time I went alone to the gym. Call me strange, but even though I like the clashing of iron and the aroma of sweat and tears, I go to a 24-hour gym at around 10 at night when no one else is there. All the big lifts are open. Unlike in the morning or early evening where you have to rep in with someone to get anything done. Sometimes I like to take my shirt off, and I get yelled at for that during the day as well. It's a small gym with a parking lot that can fit maybe 10 cars. The occupancy of the gym is also rather low, but it has a flexible schedule, so it helps disperse it out a bit. I parked very close to the front door. So that way if I am exhausted from a hard workout I would not have to travel far when I am leaving. I entered the dark gym which had motion-activated lights that were late to activate. It was time to get to work. Everything up to incline press went pretty nicely. My bench and dumbbell press had seen slight improvement, which is always nice. When I went to the incline, I noticed the window coverings are raised. It makes sense because during the day some sunlight gets in, but in the dark it was creepy. I went up to try to close them and just as I did the motion-activated lights timer went out. Guess I wasn't moving enough or something. So I ran around for a bit, and eventually, they turned back on. Then I mustered the courage to attempt to close the coverings again and did so. One of the lights was now flickering in the corner, which I thought was strange. I closed the coverings and resumed my workout. After a while, a few more lights were flickering and the first one was out. I had to use the bathroom before I did some cardio. You always have to use the bathroom before you run. I walked in and did my business, and before I started washing my hands I heard a loud crash even through my headphones. I sprinted towards the door and thrust it open to greet whatever had made the noise, but what I saw confused me. It was dark and nearly impossible to see, so I used my phone's flashlight. From the ceiling, there was a large amount of debris in front of the squat rack. From the rather large hole, I saw cut wires, the excess could not be found anywhere. So I anxiously look around for whatever caused it while approaching the exit. Right next to the front entrance there is an office. The door is now unlocked and pried open slightly with a trail of dust leading from the hole. Whatever I assume intentionally caused the ruckus and cut the wires was in the office. So after gathering my courage and turning off my light for a few seconds to get the drop on them, I turn my light on and dart around the corner as fast I could. In the office there was nothing. Some papers were on the floor from the two desks in the room. I was thinking that whoever the vandal was, they may have left through the office's front entrance to avoid getting caught. FYI, there are two entrances, one in the main workout area and one in the office. But I'm not listening to music anymore, so I would certainly have heard it. Just to be safe, I would assume that they were still in the room with me. But if I was the target for whatever scheme they were playing, they would likely be outside to greet me or hiding under the desks. Better yet, on the roof again. I decided to sit silently and wait for any sign of life. Whether it be slight rustling or a glint of someone trying to find me. I sat there for what felt like minutes. Eventually, my heart drowned out any other sound that was being made, so I decided to leave the building. The doors opened outward, so I could look through the crack between the hinges and the door on the exposed side of the front of the entrance. I saw no one around, so I began to approach my car slowly and carefully. I was going to check around my car to see if anyone was around it. But before I could, about 10 meters away, I saw a silhouette peering around the corner. They must have listened for my footsteps or the door opening and closing. They noticed I saw them and began sprinting. Without thinking, I ran because there was a road nearby with a supermarket, so hopefully, that would dissuade their pursuit. After being thankful I was going to do my cardio running workout last today, I reached the parking lot of the supermarket. Then I pull out my phone and start dialing 911. Meanwhile, from the tree line, I could see the shadow looking at me. The silhouette was a large man, not fat but pretty heavy and clearly so. His ominous heavy frame was intimidating with every stretch as he strode forward. With his height, large hands, and bulky muscle size that, by the way, did not look natty. It was like he did not care if he knew I saw him or not. He was just at the tree line pacing back and forth in a hypnotic rhythm. I continued to get distance from him, but no matter what, he looked as though he was still slightly approaching. He was slightly approaching. In a gait similar to jumping back over and over again. My call was finally answered and I told them my exact location. But just as I had done so, the large man sprints behind a pillar from the structure of the market. I decided my best bet would be to run into the open parking lot and keep my eye out. He might be big, but I'm faster. Standing in the middle of the parking lot like a lost child, I kept my eyes on the corners of the building to see if he would try to flank me. Surely I saw a large shadow bolt into the tree line. Just then did I see blue lights arrive behind me. He seemed to have run at the sight of them. After taking my statement of the situation, I asked the officer and his partner to take me to my car. I lived about 10 minutes from the gym by car. They obliged and we were on our way. I told them about the large man and his intimidating size. I was not willing to go anywhere alone at this point and I urged them not to either. We got to the gym, and they led me to my car where I then drove away. While they investigated the incident, I don't know why he chased me. Perhaps he thought I saw his face, or I was his target all along. Since then, I never go to the gym without Ross or at least somebody else. Heck, sometimes I even take my mom. The man didn't have any clearly defined features except for his size. There's a lot of big guys that go to the gym, especially the owner. But why would he want to do any of this? It is still currently under investigation, and I'm both a witness and suspect of the property damage. I'll keep you guys posted if there are any new developments.